Hey everyone, when you think of the Japanese Shinkansen, what comes to mind? For a lot of people, the first things are probably its speed, how it zips us to our destinations, and the high-quality, comfortable ride. I think it's fair to say most people have a pretty positive impression of the bullet train. I use the Shinkansen myself when I travel around Japan, and for Japanese people, it's considered safer and faster than flying or taking a bus, so a ton of people benefit from it. But it's not just the trains themselves that are cool. The stations are fascinating too. The stations where the Shinkansen stops are basically the transportation hubs of a region, so you can actually get a good sense of the local vibe just by exploring the station itself. Now, I've heard that some of these stations are in some pretty unexpected, out-of-the-way places. The one I'm going to introduce you to is exactly like that. It's a station located deep in nature, literally carved out of a mountain, nestled between a major city and a vast wilderness. So, what kind of station do you think it is?
The station I've come to today is the Shin-Kobe Station on the Shinkansen line. As you can see, it's not just a bullet train station, the subway runs here too. The reason it has a subway station attached has to do with its really unique history. Shin-Kobe Station wasn't a station that was already there. It was actually built on purpose back in 1972, and before that, it was just a mountain. As I mentioned in my last video, Kobe already has a traditional train station called Kobe Station, but it was physically impossible to run the Shinkansen through it. That's because Kobe's downtown area is a long, narrow strip running east to west, squeezed between mountains to the north and the sea to the south. That means there's a limited amount of flatland available for a train line. That land is already densely packed with high-rise condos and homes, so it would have been incredibly difficult to acquire it for the new Shinkansen line. As a result, they came up with the idea to literally carve a path through the mountain to build the station and the tracks. It's a surprisingly bold and ambitious idea, isn't it? The Shin in Shin-Kobe Station means new in Japanese. So the name basically means it's a new terminal station built in a different location from the original central Kobe Station. Now you can understand why there are no trains running on the surface here. It's just physically impossible. And that's exactly why they built the subway line here instead.
So with all that in mind, let's actually take a look at Shin-Kobe Station. Technically, the station is inside a mountain, so it's a bit removed from Sannomiya, which is the biggest downtown area in Kobe. But it's surprisingly close. It only takes about 10 minutes on the subway from Shin-Kobe to Sannomiya. This really highlights the unique geography of the city, which is surrounded by both mountains and the sea. But don't forget that this conveniently close location has a major downside, which we'll get into later. Just look at this massive tunnel. It was made by drilling straight through the mountain. Kobe is just seriously short on flat land, so the only way to create more space for train lines, roads, and neighborhoods is to either shave down mountains or build artificial islands. If you look at it from above, you can see how the roads gradually slope uphill towards Shin-Kobe Station. And the view of Kobe from the station is incredible too.
Inside the station, there are all sorts of shops, and it's pretty lively with local specialties and bento boxes to eat on the bullet train. That said, since Shin-Kobe Station was built by cutting through a mountain, there's no flat land and it doesn't connect to the regular train lines. Because of that, it's actually quite a bit smaller compared to the Shinkansen stations in places like Osaka or Kyoto. Even though Kobe doesn't really have one single super famous specialty, there are a few things that are really popular. For example, Kobe pudding is famous, and financiers are also a popular souvenir. You might think of traditional Japanese sweets when you think of Japan, but since Kobe is a very international city, it's actually a great place to find some amazing Western-style pastries. And of course, when you talk about Kobe, Kobe beef is world famous. It's super expensive, but the taste is absolutely top-notch. It literally melts in your mouth. So you should definitely try some authentic Kobe beef if you ever get the chance.
So that's a quick tour of Shin-Kobe Station. As you can see, it really feels like just a simple gateway to the city, and it's not a place you'd want to hang out for a long time. From here, you've got three main choices. You can take the subway to Sannomiya, the main downtown area. You can go to the big shopping mall directly connected to the station, or you can head out into the great outdoors nearby. Today, we're going with the latter two. First, let's check out the shopping mall. It's called Kotono-hako Kobe. It was originally built back in 1992 to help liven up the station since it didn't have much going on, but now it's pretty infamous. People even call it a living ruin.
Apparently, this mall was built with the hope that it could compete with Sannomiya. But man, it's pretty bad. It has absolutely no energy, and it's in such a terrible state that over 70% of the shops are empty. Ultimately, Shin-Kobe Station has little value other than being a Shinkansen stop. It couldn't stop the flow of people who, upon arriving in Kobe, just instinctively think, let's just go to Sannomiya. To give you an example from the U.S., Shin-Kobe Station is kind of like the Amtrak station at Dulles Airport, where the core functions of Washington, D.C. are still concentrated at Union Station and downtown. Plus, since the U.S. is so car-centric, maybe that's why new stations out in the suburbs really struggle to attract people. It just goes to show how difficult it is to be a hub station. The gravity of a strong city center is just too powerful. When Kotono-hako Kobe was built, the idea was to create multiple urban centers in Kobe. But there was no demand for that in the first place. And while they aimed for 8 million annual visitors, they're reportedly getting less than half of that. It's wild how strong the pull of the city center can be, both in Japan and the US.
It's a ghost town, no question about it. However, Shin-Kobe Station is still a crucial hub for the Shinkansen, and about 30,000 people use it every day. Because of that, they can't just completely get rid of all the commercial facilities. A building directly connected to a station is positioned as an amenity for people to at least have some basic services. Plus, there's a hotel from the Japanese airline ANA on the upper floors of Kotono-hako Kobe. This creates a certain level of demand for things like izakayas and souvenir shops for hotel guests, which makes it difficult to completely shut the whole thing down. And here's the biggest issue, though. The city of Kobe was involved in the development, so a full closure would be a bad look for the local government. This is a kind of bad habit in Japan. There are a lot of ruins all over the country that are kept because they are cherished memories, even if they are completely unprofitable. In places like the US, a large shopping mall directly attached to a station might be rare, and facilities like this that don't quite work out would probably be abandoned. I saw a YouTube video the other day about how old abandoned malls in the US are being redeveloped into homes and offices. I think it would be cool if Japan did something similar, but what do you think? I just want to experience living in a shopping mall myself.
Anyway, the bottom line is that the Kotono-hako Kobe shopping mall was expected to be a major commercial hub to rival Sannomiya, but is facing a harsh reality with over 70% of its space currently vacant. However, that's not the only way to enjoy Shin-Kobe Station. In fact, what really makes this station special is the entertainment that takes full advantage of its location. Nature. Even though Shin-Kobe Station is just a 10-minute train ride from the major city of Sannomiya, it's literally built into a mountain. That's why they say it's the Shinkansen station with the closest proximity to both a major city and nature in all of Japan. To give you a US example, it's like if Union Station in downtown LA had a hiking trail just a few minutes walk from the exit. Maybe Vancouver is a better comparison, with the North Shore Mountains right behind downtown and the ocean right in front. If you go behind Shin-Kobe Station, you'll see a towering mountain. And I hear you can get an incredible view just by walking for 10 minutes up this mountain. So let's go check it out.
That's wild, right? Who would have thought there'd be a hiking trail right behind the station? This is exactly what makes Kobe so great. If you live in this huge city but want a taste of nature, you can just pop over here. It totally makes sense why Kobe is so popular as a place to live. Kobe is kinda like San Francisco. Just like how you have houses on hills like Russian Hill and Nob Hill, Kobe also has to shave down the sides of mountains to create residential areas for people to live. The difference is that in San Francisco, you find hills everywhere, but in Kobe, the slopes get really steep once you start heading toward the mountains. So I hear if you walk up these stairs for about 5 minutes, you can get an amazing view. So let's get going. Normally, a hike takes hours. But if you take the Shinkansen to Shin-Kobe Station, you can be done in under 10 minutes. How's that for an easy sightseeing plan? As I walked up the mountain, I saw a bunch of other tourists who must have just arrived. It seems like it's a routine for everyone, both Japanese and foreign tourists, to get to Shin-Kobe Station and immediately hike up the mountain behind it.
We've made it. This is Nunobiki Falls, which has been considered one of Japan's three most sacred waterfalls since ancient times. Out of all the famous waterfalls in Japan, this one is particularly well known. There are four falls here, but this one is the main one, called the Otaki Falls, and it's 43 meters high. It's truly incredible that such a massive waterfall and so much nature exists right behind Shin-Kobe Station with all of its skyscrapers. They say if you go up a little higher, you can get a great view of Kobe, an international port city, so let's check it out. This is the observation deck. When you look at the view from here, you can really see just how close the mountains and the sea are. There probably aren't many other cities this big in Japan that are so surrounded by nature. Kobe is Japan's sixth largest city by population, and the massive economic area that includes Osaka, Kyoto, and Kobe is the second largest in Japan after the Tokyo metropolitan area. The port of Kobe, which you can see from here, was even called the world's number one container port after the war, and to this day, it's a representative international trading port for Japan, serving as a hub for imports, exports, and international logistics. In that sense, Kobe is probably similar to San Francisco or Seattle. Both of those cities developed around their ports and share the same kind of geography, with mountains and the sea so close together. However, San Francisco and Seattle have been able to successfully embrace new industries like Silicon Valley and the tech industry, while Kobe seems to be getting left behind. Its population is gradually being absorbed by Osaka and Tokyo, but I really hope it can regain its momentum as a major city again.
So that's our deep dive into Shin-Kobe Station, the hidden Shinkansen station in the mountains. We learned that because of Kobe's unique geography, the station was literally carved out of a mountain. It still serves as a gateway for visitors from other prefectures, but it's also facing the frustrating reality of never being able to become Kobe's second downtown. But the best part was definitely Nunobiki Falls and the incredible view of Kobe from the observation deck right behind the station. I'd love to go back if I get the chance, and I hope you'll consider using Shin-Kobe Station if you ever get to visit Japan. Thanks for watching!